Presenting a mail composer view in SwiftUI is challenging because SwiftUI doesn't have a built-in mail compose view controller like UIKit does, requiring developers to bridge UIKit using UIViewControllerRepresentable. Handling delegates, dismissing the view properly, and ensuring compatibility across different iOS versions adds extra complexity. This video will walk you through the entire process, step by step, making it easy to integrate email functionality into your SwiftUI apps seamlessly. And if you want to talk with me on a one-on-one Zoom call, go ahead and check out the link in the description. More on this later in the video. Now, today we are going to talk about how to present a mail view. So for that, what I have done is just basically started off with a brand new Xcode project. We are going to basically tap on a button and the mail view should be displayed. And of course, we should be able to add recipients and then a subject and a body. Okay, so we are going to create a kind of a sheet-like view modifier. So it's going to be like mail view, and then is it presented, and then recipients, subject, and body. Those two will be optional. Okay, so first of all, this isn't available in SwiftUI just yet. Maybe it will be in a few months as WWDC is approaching. Now, we need to dig down into UIKit, so we are going to use a UI view controller representable. So without further ado, let's jump into the code. Let's create a new empty file, and I will name this mail view. There we go. Oh, I just added that extra character over there. There we go, and let's just remove that. So we want to import SwiftUI and the message UI, so yeah, it automatically is suggesting some stuff, but we are going to take it one step at a time. I'm going to actually make sure that you understand everything that I type. So first of all, we want to create, yes, this UI view controller representable. It doesn't have to be public, only if you are going to add it into a Swift package. So let's just type out struct mail view. It's not going to be a view, it's just going to be a UI view controller representable. There we go. And let's just add some stuff before we add in our coordinator, mail a coordinator, our make coordinator, make UI view controller, and update UI view controller. Okay, so we are going to need to dismiss this view whenever we tap on the console button inside our composer. So let's just add an environment. Environment, and that would be not the presentation mode, that is kind of old school. We want to have the dismiss, so private var dismiss. Okay, next we want to listen to the changes of the mail composer. So we want to take a look at the results. Was it canceled? Was it sent? Was the sending canceled, or there was an error? So also we want to bind this, so at binding. We are going to bind it because we are going to take a look at it outside of the UI view controller representable. Binding var result. And that will be MF mail component result of type area. That suggestion is really nice. Now, also, we want to add the recipients. So let recipients, it's an array of strings. And then we want to have a subject. And I want to make the subject optional. Yeah, you could just add your subject or just add nil. And then body the same thing. So body optional string. Now, let's create our coordinator because we want to listen to the delegate methods that the mail composer has. So that's how we do it with the UI view controller representable. I know make UI view controller is required. That's why we have this error, and also update UI view controller, but we are going to get there. First of all, let's create our coordinator. So that will be a class coordinator. Let's see. It has to adhere to NS object, definitely. MF mail compose view controller delegate. Yes, that's what we need right over here. So first of all, I want to grab the parent so I can dismiss, so call on this dismiss view. So let's just have a variable called parent. And that will be a mail view, yes. And then, yeah, I think this is fine. Let me just double check. So the initializer is fine. So we do need, and this should be parent equals parent. So the initial is fine. We do need to set the parent as the mail view. And then let's take a look at this. Did finish with the result? Well, yeah, it should dismiss. But if there's an error, we should tell the error. So we should just set the result, this one. If it's not, then if there are no errors, of course, then we should just simply set the success of that result. So instead of dismiss right over here, we are going to defer, and then we are going to take a look at the error. If let error equals error, we are going to complete with failure. So, well, set the result to failure. Otherwise, it should be success. Yes, AI is really, really nice at suggesting these things for me right now. As an IS developer, the right mentor can make all the difference between years of struggle and rapid success. That's where my one-on-one mentoring sessions come in. I offer personalized, hands-on coaching tailored to your specific goals, whether you're just starting out or refining your skills. With extensive experience in iOS development and a proven track record of helping developers grow, I will guide you past common challenges, help you master SwiftUI, and fast-track your journey to building high-quality apps. Let's elevate your iOS development skills. The link is down in the description. Finally, we want to add the make coordinator. So this is our class. It just ends right over here. And then let's create our make coordinator. Yes, it will be of type coordinator. And then just go coordinator. We are going to have a parent of self. Okay, now it's time to go ahead and create those make UI view controller and update UI view controller. So just start typing I make UI view controller. And yeah, this suggestion is fine, but I want to change the UI view controller to the MF mail compose view controller. So MF mail compose view controller, just like that. Okay, so let's create it. So let view controller equals MF mail view compose view controller. There we go. Then we want to set the delegate, because that's why we created our coordinator. So view controller dot mail compose delegate equals our context coordinator. Yes. And then let's just see what's suggesting over here. VC set recipients, that's fine. And then if there's a subject, then set the subject. If there's a body, set the body and return the view controller. Now, AI is really smart about this. Most probably it's just learned a lot about my previous attempts of creating this. Yes. So this is what you want to do. Set the recipients. If there's a subject, set it. If there's a body, set it. If not, then just omit it. Okay. And then finally, when we want to go for the update UI view controller and UI view. Well, yeah, let's just add the type also instead of just the generic type. So UI view controller of type MF mail compose view controller, and then the context. Okay, we are not going to do anything on the update. We are listening to the delegate method, so we don't need anything to add right over here. And then finally, I also want to check if we can send email. If you are going to run this on the simulator, you will see that you can't actually send emails from the simulator. Now, if you are going to run it from the device, you will be able, if you have the mail, at least the mail client mail app added, installed into your application. So let's just have that as a static function, and then can send email or just mail. Okay, that will be a Boolean value. And then that will be MF mail compose view controller can send mail. Yes. So we're just going to return that. Really, really nice. So this is our view controller representable. What we want to do is just, as I told you at the beginning of this tutorial, we want to create some sort of a view modifier. Now, to create that view modifier, we need to create an actual view modifier. And I'm just going to do it right over here. Let's just type out view modifier. And it's just going to suggest the default values. Let's just use that. And I'm going to remove the preview. We don't need that at this stage. And I'm going to rename this to Mail View Modifier. Okay. I'm going to remove every just default value over there. So what do we want? We want to present it as a sheet would be presented. So we are going to have a binding right over here. Binding var is presented of type bool. As you know, bindings, you don't set the default values, you just set their types. And also we want to grab the recipient, subject, and body. For that, I'm just going to copy these out and paste them in there. You know, we're just going to pass them along. Finally, we want to track the mail composer results. And for that, we are going to, of course, create a mail composer results, but we're also going to show an alert if that is the case. So let's just have these as state variables. So state var, yeah, result, that's fine. I'm going to name this as a mail a result, so we can just see the differences. It should be an optional, yes, and the default value should be nil. You know, for state variables, we need to give their default values if they are not optional, but I tend to do add a nil value also right over there. Now, let's take care of the alert message too. So state variable, state, and then private. Let's add private also here, private, var, alert message, and that will be an optional type of string. And yeah, default value should be nil. And then we are going to have a Boolean value actually right over here, not a string value, a Boolean, which is false. And instead of alert message, of course, is alert presented with a capital A. Okay, so we have all of our required properties. Now it's time to create it. So basically what we are going to do is just present the mail view, you know, the UI view controller representable inside a sheet. So right over here on the content, I'm just going to go sheet, and let's just choose the one with the is presented and content. This is fine, so we are using the is presented and content. I'm not going to use the can send email, can send mail right over here. We are going to do that on the content view itself. Now I'm just going to go mail view and then pass along everything. So mail view results, let's just bind the mail result, and then recipients, and then subject, and then body. There we go. Let's take care of this error. So I'm going to add the parentheses right over there. Okay, so we are also going to need to listen to the mail result. So let's just go ahead and add an onDisappear, so dot onDisappear. We want to take a look at the results when this sheet has been dismissed, of course, on disappear. And what we are going to take a look at is this mail result. As you can see, it's binded to the mail view. So if it's nil, then of course we are not going to do anything, but yeah, usually we are going to have is let if let result equals mail result, and then we want to switch through the results. Now, yeah, this is just suggesting that we take a look at the error. There's much more to that, and I'm not going to type that out manually. I'm just going to copy it out right over here from my notes and just paste it in there. So copying and pasting. Let me just indent everything. So shift Command A and then Control I. Okay. And I believe, yeah, is alert presented. This is much nicer warning than alert is presented. Is alert presented. And yeah, that should be it. And then also right over here, is alert presented equals true if there was an error. There we go. Okay, so that's how you are listening to the changes. But we set the alert message and then we want to present the alert. But the alert is nowhere to be found. So right over here, after on disappear, or rather, not on the on disappear, on the mail view itself, or after the sheet. Yeah, let's just add this after the sheet so it's on the content view itself. So we are going to have an alert, yes. Is presented, is alert presented, that's fine. And then let's take a look at this suggestion. Text, well, not error, let's just use this, but it shouldn't be an error. It should be just an alert from the mail. And then we're going to have alert message. If there is no alert, then unknown error. Yeah, that's fine. And the dismiss button, default text. Okay, perfect. Okay, so now whenever we have a result, whenever we just cancel or the email is sent, we are going to send present all of these inside an alert, which is really nice. Okay. Now, this is a view modifier. Here comes the final step, basically the third step to that view modifier. This is, I know, it's a view modifier, it's a struct, but we actually want that dot notation. So for that, we are going to create an extension on the view. So right over here, extension, view, and then let's create a function called MailView. Mail view, yeah, that's fine. I'm just going to add self right over here. And now let's add in the requirements. So first of all, I want to bind the is presented, because remember, we are going to show this whenever we tap on the button. So it should be something like the sheet. So we are going to add is presented, and it will be a binding bool, that's right. And then we also want to add the recipients, subject and the body. So let's type that out, recipients. Multiple recipients are allowed, so it's an array of strings, and then subject and body. Both should be optional, and by default we should add the value nil, so we don't have to type out nil all the time when we want to omit them. Okay, so these are our properties, and then it's pretty straightforward. We are just going to say modifier, and then just choose our mail view modifier, and then just pass along everything else. So is presented, recipients, subject, and then the body. And basically that's it. Now we want to actually use it. So we have the UI view controller representable, we have our view modifier, which in turn is set up inside a view extension. Let's go to the content view, and now let's set things up. What I'm going to do is just remove everything right over here, button, and then let's just have a show mail, that's fine. And then let's have a state variable for that, at state private var show mail. Yeah, that's fine. So I'm just going to go show a mail dot toggle, and let's just have that mail view, and as you can see, if it's presented, and also we all want to add our recipients, optionally subject or body. Yeah, and by the way, I did not know tell you this, but the body is set to be non-HTML, so it's set to false. If you are going to send some HTML as the body, then just set that back to true. Okay, so let's bind this. Show mail, and then the recipients, you know, me at gmail.com. And that this should be an actual string. And it is indeed an array. Now, if you are in a simulator, of course, this will not work, because the simulator does not have any, you know, sending out email functionality, but the button still would be able, it's tappable. So what we want to do, and this is quite important in terms of UX, you want to add in a disabled, so dot, it should be disabled. When should it be disabled? When it cannot send any email. So not mail view dot can send mail. And then if you can't send any emails, then it will be disabled. Otherwise, you may be able to tap on the button and send that nice email with a slide of a sheet. And that's it. If you like these types of tutorials, go ahead and check out my mentoring sessions. The link is down in the description.